I think we're alone now. The beat of my heart is the only sound.
Hi, it's me. If you don't know what I'm doing is I'm doing a look back at Keith Lemon's Very Brilliant World Tour. It happened back in 2008. It was a long time. It was before Celebrity Juice, before Fruit Keel, before the Keith Lemon sketch show. This episode I'm looking at is when I went to Egypt. Egypt was memorable for me because it was my first experience of getting piles after riding a camel for 2.5 hours. I got off the camel and I said to the crew, of which was very small, there's only 5 of us. We had no makeup and costume and stuff, you just 5 dudes. I got off the camel and I said, guys, my bumhole doesn't feel right. Anyway, it turned out I had piles. It was a long story. Anyway, if you ever get piles, it's difficult to first put up this suppository because your bum says, no, nothing's going in. Things come out of this, you can't go in. And I can remember trying to put the suppository in it and my bum was like, no, man. And then suddenly it went, okay, I'll take that from you. I've told that story many a time, but I did panic that actually I have no control over my sphincter. And that was back in Egypt. I remember when we were flying over the River Nile on a hot air balloon, I almost felt drunk with pain. Let's have a look. I'll press play here.
Mom, it's Keith.
That's me.
You never guess where I am.
Back when I had yellow hair. That's me with yellow hair and Crocs.
Yeah.
How things have changed. Yeah. Let's go full screen.
Yeah.
Mom, it's Keith. You never guess where I am. I'm in Egypt. Yeah? 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 No? All right then, ta-da!
My name's Keith Lemon, businessman of the year 93, inventor of the Tikiori Pole. I'm about to embark on a very brilliant world tour, touring around the world, whilst my cousin Gary looks after my business. My next door neighbour Roy is filming the whole thing using a video camera and some tapes.
Why's my face scribbled out?
Shut up, Roy, I haven't finished voiceover. What is this programme? It's Keith Lemon's Very Brilliant World Tour. I'd been on my world tour now for 4 half-hour episodes. Following my shark-shaped flight plan, I'd arrived in Egypt, which is situated on the outskirts of the shark's rectum, and my rectum was having an hard time of it. It had blisters on it the size of ping-pong balls on account of riding this bloody camel.
Sure, it's got a taxi.
This week, I'll be ballooning in a hot air balloon, taking Samia Smith from Coronation Street on the camel safari thing, snorkelling in the deep blue Red Sea, and having a slashback about my X Factor audition with Sharon Osbourne.
You haven't got the X Factor, darling.
I have.
You don't.
I drink it and I eat it.
Egypt is known for its majestic tombs, temples of the pharaohs, and the Red Sea. And of course, the all-out adventure movie, The Mummy, starring Brandon Fraser. And The Mummy Returns, starring Brandon Fraser. Roy, is it Brandon Fraser or is it Michael Douglas?
It's Brendan Fraser.
It is Brandon Fraser. Michael Douglas starred in Jewel of the Nile, which was also set here in Egypt. And you thought I was fake. As I walked the streets of Cairo, I felt like I stuck out like a sore finger. I needed to look inconspicuous and less like Hannibal Lecter when he was in disguise as the man from Del Monte rather than a vicious carnivore. There was also a language barrier with the language barrier.
Mouthwash? Mouthwash?
Mouthwash?
No, thanks.
Acid?
Oh no, I don't can't drink acid. See you later.
So I decided to get myself some authentic Egyptian clobber so I could fit in more inconspicuously.
No, it's not Lawrence of Arabia. It's me, Keith Lemon. But as you can see, I'm dressed in the complete attire that Lawrence of Arabia would wear if he was indeed to go on a camel safari. And that's what I'm just about to be doing. Oh, look over there. It's Samia Smith who plays Maria in Coronation Street. I wonder what she's doing here. Let's find out.
here.
What the frickin' hell are you doing in Egypt? What a surprise!
You told me to be here. You told me to meet you at the tree.
No, do the thing where you know, you said you're hitchhiking at Coronation Street. Just do that, for sure.
Yeah, I feel a bit stupid holding this up,
just though,
okay?
Just do it for program, will you? I actually know Sam here. She's one of my clients. I've stuck an erection in a passage, a security pole. Anyway, let's commence with the camel safari. Just go down that shop. Oh, well, here we are with a pack of camels, which is commonly known as a bonbon. And we're going to learn about some of the camel's features, what it does and stuff. Do you know about camels?
Just that I'm really scared of them.
Well, don't be scared. We'll have a tutorial and we'll see what they're all about. So this is our man here. What's your name?
Samir.
Samir?
Samir.
His name is Samir as well. That's a coincidence, isn't it? So, Samir, tell me what that thing is at the front there that looks very dangerous.
The lips. He got three lips. Actually, he used the ones down to get his food, to
one,
eat his
one
food.
One lip to eat his food.
Other one to use it to kiss his girlfriend.
To kiss his girlfriend.
Third one to catch his, to hold his joint.
To hold his joint?
Yeah.
Oh, he's got indigestion. Oh, you dirty git. So what's this bit here, all this tent thing? What's this rubbish?
Just down of it. This is a seat.
This is a seat? What's that thing there?
This is the tail of the camel.
That's his tail?
Yeah, this is. What's that one you mean?
What are them under there, those two things?
This is the balls.
That's his balls. Samir, here's where his testicles are. Do you know what they are?
Yeah, I'm not in the mood for joking, Keith. I'm really nervous.
No, I'm not joking. We're learning. I'm just, for people at home who've never seen a camel, we're going through what it is. Don't get irate with us, okay?
All right.
Calm down. So I think we've learned enough about camels. Samir, you sort of, you know what to expect and stuff, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, let's go on a camel safari.
Oh, the way she mounted the 33-lipped beast, it sent a quiver down me private sectors.
All right.
She was bang tidy.
It'd be good on Coronation Street if someone came into Rover's Return with a flamethrower and burnt everyone.
But then all the characters would have to die.
Yeah, kill them all off. And then all poor buggers that used to be in Brookside who aren't working anymore, they could get jobs again, because Sinbad's in it now, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's in it.
After about 6.5 hours on those bleeding camels, my ass felt like it had been kicked in. So as night fell, we settled down for a romantic firelight meal thing.
Would you like any more dead sheep, Samir?
No, I'm full, thank you.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I've had loads.
There you go, Trevor. You can eat that. You've got a beautiful colour on you. You
know, oh, cheers.
Ask me what my favourite colour is.
What's your favourite colour?
Hot dog.
Aw. Well...
I like cream as well.
Yeah.
I said cream. She knew what I meant.
I like this bread. It's different, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's Egyptian bread.
Mm. You got a bit of Egyptian in you.
A bit Egyptian?
You got a bit of Egyptian in you?
No, my dad's from Lebanon.
Lebanon sounds like lesbian, doesn't it?
Yeah, I suppose so.
If I do one, will you? You can keep that meat.
OK.
I'm going to get a bit romantic. I think we're alone now. There doesn't seem to be anyone around. I think we're alone now. The beat of my heart is the only sound. Running just as fast as we can. Running, running, running. Trying to hold on to each other's hands. Trying to get away into the night. And then we tumble to the ground and then we say,
you fancy being a slut back there with me and doing some exotic stuff like that 88 where it's upside down?
Bullseye. The cat was in the bag, sleeping bag. Fade to black, cause the next minute and a half is so rude it'll make your eyes bleed.
Samir. Oh, Samir. Oh, yes.
Insert cream with the applicator into the rectum. Stick that in my bum. Ah. This ain't just a joke for television. I think I've got piles, and I think it's from riding camels. I
can't believe I'm sticking my finger in my bum bum.
I left yesterday behind, and it was now tomorrow. But my behind was still very much today, as I was still in excruciating pain from my piles, and I was in no mood to do anything today or tomorrow.
We got up at about 4 o'clock this morning because Roy the cameraman wants to come on a hot air balloon ride. It means you avoid all the mithers trying to sell you special Egyptian paper called papyrus and little lighters shaped like pyramids and sphincters. Thanks.
As you can see, a hot air balloon isn't the most exhilarating or fastest means of transportation. And if you're thinking of commuting to work on one, you best phone your boss and tell him you're going to be late.
Well, as you can see, we're now airborne. I'll introduce you to our captain, Captain Mohammed. Keith, now, is Captain Mohammed, yeah?
Captain Mahmoud.
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 Mah.
Mah.
Mah. Yes, good.
Captain Mahmoud.
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 Yes.
Mahmoud.
Mahmoud.
Mahmoud. Yes. How long are we up in the air for? Before it runs out and we plummet to our death.
You must be landing after 10 minutes maximum, yeah.
10 minutes maximum, yes. Maximum you can fly for. Suppose that's a bit of a downfall in design if your journey is in fact 10 and a half minutes. Look, looks like EastEnders. Dun, 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 dun. Boof, 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 boof. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. How long have we been in air now?
35 minutes.
We've been in air 35 minutes. So I think there's a miscalculation on Mahmoud's part.
Mahmoud.
Mahmoud.
Yes.
Well, we're starting to go on our descent right now. Our 10 minutes are up.
Mahmoud
is going to have a refill. Let's hope it's a safe landing. Fingers crossed. We don't want to crash onto somebody's poor little head. Move, we're going to squash you. We're going to squash you. Move our way. You're going to wreck all these crops.
Yeah.
You're going to squash them all.
Landing position now.
Landing position, oh, now.
Yes.
Landing position! Get down, you pillocks! What are you filming, Roy? Don't be filming your crutch! Here we are! Oh! Oh! Yeah. Oh! Happy landing! Happy landing! I'd like to thank Mahmoud. We're being greeted by all his friends.
Okay.
And then we finish with an Egyptian sing song. My very brilliant world tour here in Egypt had started off with a good bang. Thanks, Samir Smith from Coronation Street. I'd had an exhilarating hot air balloon ride with Captain Mahmoud.
Mahmoud!
And I'd just recruited none other than Jeff Goblin from Jurassic Park to be my voice translator.
Let's have a picture, though. Fitting image. Anyway, Jeff, stop being messing about. Let's commence. Come on. The roads are in a bit of a mess, aren't they, Jeff?
No,
what's
just
all this about? Well, be careful in here, Roy. Look at roads. Right, shit tip. It's all kicking off in this sector. This is the spice sector, where they sell all spices, isn't it? Is this coming out, so? Excuse you. Yes, excuse you. Excuse you. All right, love. Good. What are them?
Tamarind.
Is it cow shit?
No. Tamarind drink.
What do they do? Heat it up?
Yeah, they put in water.
Yeah. That ball of shit there, you eat it up and drink that. Won't give that to me, dog.
Watch your back.
Yeah, I won't.
As we strolled through Cardicaledy Market, Jeff, my translator, insisted we held hands. To be frank, I was a bit uncomfortable with it, but Jeff told me it was a way of expressing manuality here in Egypt and had not to do with homosexuality.
It's the manuality thing again.
Yeah,
it's the manuality.
Jeff seemed to know a lot of fellas here in the market, including Ashraf, the Lord Mayor of Egypt.
You're just telling me the time you went to see Boyzone in Cairo and you got on stage and you did what? You did... He pulled his pants down. Just like Jarvis Cocker did to Michael Jackson. But he did it to... He did it to Ronan Keating. I'm just about to tell him the story about the time when I met Sharon Osbourne when I went in for X Factor. Let me tell him. I went in for X Factor. Got to boot camp as well, you know.
Oh.
Hello. Boot camp, yeah.
Hi, Sharon. My name's Keith Lemon, businessman of the year 93. I'm Jade. And together, as the complete unit, we are up north.
All right then, guys. What are you going to sing for me today?
Well, today, Sharon, we're going to sing an Aaron Neville cover by Aaron Neville. Don't Know Much by Aaron Neville.
Fabulous. Okay.
2, 3, 4. Look at this face.
I'm not the face I show it.
Look at this life.
I still don't know where I'm going.
I don't know much,
but I love you.
That may be
all that I need to know. Yeah.
What was that?
That was the cover of I Don't Know Much by Aaron Neville.
Keith, I know that. I know that, darling, but... You were doing a really bad impersonation of Aaron Neville. It was like a comedy.
It was a bit of an impersonation.
You just really don't have it. And in fact, to be blatantly honest with you, I think you're holding him back. Jade could do well on his own.
Yeah, yeah.
Would you consider coming back and doing something else on your own?
Yeah. Hold on a minute. If it weren't for me, he'd still be working at Weatherlight Windows. Not even up front, on desk, right at back, cleaning things.
That is all beside the point. Look.
I'll prove to you, Sharon,
Keith,
come on.
Keith, let me just tell you, you do not have the X Factor. You just don't. It was like a comedy. Jade could do well on his own. You do not have the X Factor. You just don't.
I've got kids. I'm doing this with kids.
You don't have kids. I've looked on your resume.
I don't. One of them's going to die.
When?
When it's a bit older. Come on. I've got a disease.
Keith.
I've got a disease from that girl. Ah, the pain of the disease comes to and fro. I don't even know when it's going to come. You just give me a chance.
You haven't got the X Factor, darling.
I have.
You don't.
I drink it and I eat it.
You know what, look.
Are you speaking Punjabi? Because I can't understand the word you're saying.
Don't speak Punjabi. I speak the truth.
Like
and the truth is, Keith, that you've just got to go upstairs. Pack your bag, darling, and you've just got to go.
I think I've lost my case. I can't leave. Just give me another chance.
Your journey's ended here.
Well, thanks.
I'm sorry, Keith.
Thanks for nothing.
Just because she's married to that Oswald Osborne, she thinks she knows everything. I often have backflashes about that day, and you know what? I didn't need Sharon Osborne to put me on the map. I was already on the map. Egypt to be Pacific, the Red Sea to be even more Pacific.
Right now, I'm with my very good friend and snorkel expert. What's your name again?
Tamir.
Basically, his snorkel skills equal the same plateau as Gary Barlow's songwriting skills. So he's a top ilk snorkeler, yeah?
Yeah.
So, Gary, tell us about this trumpet.
It's not a trumpet.
What is it, Gary?
We call it a snorkel.
That is the actual snorkel. But what if a bird lands on there and lays a nest so its babies can hatch and you know, grow and become other birds? What if that
look
happens?
Look at that.
Yeah.
From here.
Yeah, but what if there's a nearby golf course and someone tees off and the golf ball lands on here?
No, don't worry, it's never happened.
What if there's a little kid here and he's got a Twix but his eyes are too big for his belly and he can't he can't eat the second Twix and he shoves it down there like a naughty little child.
No, don't worry.
That's not going to happen.
I'm not going to have time.
Is there going to be dolphins?
If you're lucky. If we are lucky.
I don't want to be lucky because I don't like dolphins.
Why?
Basically, when I was about 7, I had a dream that me tallywhacker, you know, on the end of it,
yeah,
it had a fish's face. Which, as you can imagine, was a bit traumatic.
But you're a man now.
Yeah, so, I'm a man.
So you don't have to be worried about.
So if they come near me, do I just punch them out of the way?
No.
No, let's do it then.
Ready for it?
Yeah.
No. You don't have to dive inside the life jacket, okay? No. Just be quiet. Just give me the time. I will handle everything.
Oh, there. Okay. I'm sorry, I'm just nervous.
I know.
I've not snorkeled before.
Snorkeling.
That's what I said.
Yeah. Pressure!
Okay. Pressure
down on me. No. Not by your head. Just try to stand up, sir.
Okay.
Be quiet, sir.
All went in! You said it wouldn't go in, it all went in!
Be happy, you are in the Red Sea. Put your head in the water.
Why?
To see the fish.
I did what Gary said and I put my head in water, but there were only 4 fish, so I splashed around for a bit just for Gary's sake, and then I came back in.
Come on, Ryan, let's do something else.
It was me last night in Egypt, and whilst Roy the cameraman popped out to film some night shots to establish it was night, I filmed myself getting ready to go to an authentic Egyptian working men's club thing.
I've got some special stadium, I think it's called. You put the stadium in, you're there, and you make... Brad Pitt. So, It's not like Brad Pitt's now, but it will be in a minute. See you later.
It's not out of the ordinary at an authentic Egyptian working men's club thing for a transvestite to get up and do a belly dance. This specific one resembled Pete Burns from the 80s pop band Dead or Alive and Celebrity Big Brother. Would you know it? It only turned out to be his brother, Barry Burns. The craftsmanship was incredible. These Egyptian surgeons really know how to throw together a pair of high-grade bosoms, this. Ashraf, the Lord Mayor of Egypt, was enjoying himself to the fullest, and I was enjoying him, enjoying the fulfillment of the enjoyment. Well, that was Egypt, and although 64% of Egyptians have got teeth like sugar puffs, they're still very nice people, and I'm sure I'll return again one day. So until next time.
If I don't see you through a week, I'll see you through a window. Come on, Teddy, take us to Japan.
That's right.
Tokyo. Yeah, we've got a week to get there. Let's go.
Next week on Keith Lemon's Very Brilliant World Tour, I get Jasmine Outway back to my hotel room in Tokyo /Japan.
See ya. Or subscribe and whatever. I don't know what you say.